Hello, Vorthos and Mel Commander players. I'm Prospo, and I welcome you to 88 Scout. Today, we'll upgrade the Spirit Squadron Spirit's Tribal Preconstructed deck. As always, we care about the tribal flavor, so we'll upgrade this deck with this goal in mind. Hope you enjoy! The Spirit Squadron Preconstructed deck is a quite well-balanced Spirit's Tribal EDH deck. It is led by Millicent, Restless Revenant, the new most popular Spirit's Tribal commander. There are total 16 non-spirit cards in the deck, which we'll replace. There is also one card with low flavor, which we'll change with one more flavorful one. Two cards are powerful generic tribal cards. One of them will be changed. The lands count is quite low at 35, but these are okay for this deck. We will change only one land card. Finally, we will explain one combo that we have included in the deck. Let's get into it. We will start the upgrade by replacing Dovin, who creates Thopter tokens, with Ugin, the Ineffable, the powerful Planeswalker, who creates Spirit tokens with his first ability. His second ability is a powerful removal as well. Instead of Rhoda, Geist Avenger, we will add the new Katilda, Dawnheart Martyr, a really huge Spirit legend. Instead of waiting for Boreas Charger to die in order to potentially ramp us, we will add Pilgrim of the Ages at the same mana value in order to fetch immediately the land when it TBs and be ready for our land drop next turn. We will replace the powerful Fel the Mighty with Mars of Souls, a softer but more flavorful board wipe in the same mana value. Flood of Tears will give its place to Selfless Spirit. This way we'll reduce the board wipe count of our deck to 2. As we are a creature token heavy deck, Selfless Spirit will help to protect our board. Disorder in the Court is a really slow card draw spell. We will replace it with Ghastly Discovery for immediate value. Crash Contraband will give its place to Nico Ona, a spirit that potentially can destroy many enchantments. Swords of Plowshares will give its place to Skyclave Apparition, a more expensive but more versatile removal. Darksteel Mutation will be replaced with the flavorful Afterlife. Arcane Denial is undeniably a strong counterspell, but Geist Light Snare is undeniably more flavorful. The famous Imprisoned in the Moon will be replaced by Dungeon Geist, a spirit that can tap down any opposing threat. The repeatable but conditional card draw enchantment Verity Circle will be replaced by another repeatable card advantage spirit. Cemetery Illuminator is at the same mana value. The other repeatable card draw, Reconnaissance Mission, will be replaced by Ethereal Valkyrie, a powerful Spirit Angel. The powerful Knight of the White Orchid will be replaced by Soul Herder, the finisher of our combo. And Mentor of the Meek will be changed with Herald's Horn, that ramps and gives card advantage as well. Midnight Clock will be replaced by Histrionic Resonator, as it is part of our combo. The other combo piece is Brago, King Eternal. He will replace Geist of Sandcraft, a spirit with really low flavor. Distant Melody will give its place to the Ribbons of the Reikai, the same card draw effect for spirits for one more mana. Finally, we will replace the Temple of the False God with the Gates of Fistfell, the home of spirits in Galheim. This land will give some card draw and life gain. Let's move on to the flavorful combo that we have added in the deck. This combo needs Brago, King Eternal, Soul Ring, and Histrionic Resonator on the battlefield, and creates an infinite loop of ETB and leave the battlefield triggers that can be used to win the game. First, we need to deal combat damage to a player with Brago. This will trigger his ability, and you can target any number of permanents you control. While this ability is on the stack, you can pay 2 generic mana from Soul Ring to activate Histrionic Resonator's ability to copy Brago's ability. This copy will target Soul Ring, Histrionic Resonator and any spirit you control that has an ETB or leave the battlefield ability. Now we'll let the copy of the ability to resolve. This will cause Soul Ring, Histrionic Resonator and the other spirit to leave and return to the battlefield untapped. Now you can repeat the process infinite times without letting the original Brago's ability to resolve. If the spirit you flicker with this loop is Ethereal Investigator, you can create infinite clue tokens. Hanged Executioner lets you create infinite spirit tokens. Karmic Guide to reanimate all of your creatures and Nico Ona to destroy all enchantments. You can also tap down all the opposing creatures by using Dungeon Geist or Nebelgast Herald. and draw all the planes from your library with Pilgrim of the Ages. Cemetery Illuminator can exile all cards from all graveyards. And in the meantime, Soul Herder will be growing bigger and bigger, ready to swing for the win. That was our Spirits Tribal Flavorful upgrade for the Spirit Squadron pre-constructed EDH Commander deck. We replaced total 19 new Flavorful cards and removed all non-Spirit cards from the deck. We spent a bit less than $60 and added 208 flavor points. Hope you enjoyed this video and agree with the picks. Let me know in the comments below if you would have changed something else. Please like, share and subscribe. See you soon with more Tribal EDH Flavorful deck techs.